That looks incredible, doesn't it?
It does. Looks like it's floating.
Look at that.
Wow.
Look how big that is. How many rooms has that got?
It looks mythical, I was thinking.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's almost looks...
astonishing.
My God. That is one hell of a pile of bricks.
It is.
I'm hoping that we get something of real worth here, you know? I mean, look at it. Imagine trying to attack it.
Well, we're kind of on a bit of a raid ourselves, aren't we?
Oh. Good morning, gentlemen.
Hello.
How are
you doing?
Hi. Good Frankie meet you. Armstrong, nice to meet you.
Drew, how you doing?
Hi, I'm Chris.
T. Chris. Nice to meet you. Frankie Armstrong.
How are
we? Blimey. That takes your breath away, doesn't it?
A bit cold.
Yeah, it's a bit cold.
Northumbrian northeast breeze, it's fantastic.
Was that what it is?
Yes, it wakes you up.
Yes, it does. The place is amazing, and let's be honest, I'd love to have a look inside because it's probably warmer than out here.
Be my guest. Come in, gentlemen. Come in.
This building has an incredible presence in the landscape, and it sits. And it looks terrifying. It looks what it's supposed to be. It's a castle you could defend. Driving up to the castle is an experience in itself. Walking in is another one. It is just mind-blowing.
Come through then, gentlemen, please.
Wow. It's very impressive, yeah. This is... God, it's really comfortable as well, isn't it? Wow, look at this. That's amazing. Wow, it's incredible condition it's in.
Well, we're very lucky that the public come through and help us keep it standing, really.
Wow. So you've got arts and crafts pieces sort of everywhere,
yes,
with a little bit of Gothic in there. And then you've got sort of full-on neo-Gothic in there as well.
Yeah.
False Hammerbeam ceiling. 300 tonnes of Siamese teak up there.
Siamese teak?
Held together with 18-inch oak pins.
Blimey. We'll walk quite fast through there, then, shall we? The interior is magnificent. The condition is unreal. It's almost like it was built yesterday. But the feeling inside here as well is you're actually quite comfortable, and these can be quite unfriendly, uncivilized, cold places. And this one isn't, strangely.
Most of the items within the castle walls are an irreplaceable part of its history and not for sale. But Drew's been given the heads up that Francis has two old display cabinets that are surplus to requirements.
So what are we looking at these? Are these the cabinets?
Do you know where they came from?
They're probably British Museum.
Tower of London.
Tower of London?
And I've got provenance, I've got a letter to prove it.
Really?
These sarcophagus museum display cabinets, built in the 1930s, are made from English oak, with four lockable glazed bronze batwing doors and matching bronze feet. They could have a value of £1,000 each.
I've got two. Matching pair.
A matching pair.
He's in another, you'll see the other one later.
They are incredibly difficult to sell.
Really?
They are. Because they don't have a great deal of use bar retail display or museum, mm-hmm. That's it. They really, they can't be used for anything else and they can't be adapted. I'll reserve judgment for now. I know you want to get rid of them. Can we go and have a look at the other one?
Yeah, this way.
The cases, I'm going to have to be very cautious about buying them, purely because two things, they're going to take up an awful lot of room and they're not very saleable immediately, but they are a good example. They have got hassle written all over them.
Hopeful for a sale, Francis and Chris lead Drew to one of the castle's many outbuildings to see the other case.
Ah.
Yep, second case.
Second case.
More or less in exactly the same condition.
Do I want these? I think it's just going to come down to price. They'd have to be so competitively priced. I mean, give them away, because otherwise they're just a problem.
What's competitively priced?
I'd have to be led by you, really, on these. They look great in your shop, full of door handles and bits of this, that and the other. They look amazing, but try selling one. You know, so I cannot tie money up in these. If I can buy them for literally nothing, I'll buy them. They haven't got a great deal of age to them either. Do I want them? I don't really want them.
No.
Not really. So I think if I was going to make an offer, it would be a paltry offer at a couple of hundred quid each. And that is no way respects what their true worth is.
In all honesty, what do you think the true worth is?
If you got them out and into an auction house and found the keys and get all the stuff out of them, you could achieve £1,500 each or more. It is what it is. That's
200 quid each?
Yeah, you're not going to sell them to me, are you?
They're just in the way. They're going to be emptied. They're going to be stored somewhere and spoiled.
I'll get them away. I'll sell them. I'll just make them really cheap.
Sale or return.
Okay. Deal. You'll have those sold. Price them at £200 each, because that was the lowest figure I could get to that didn't sound really rude. Because what I'm doing here is I'm buying something I don't really want to get involved in. But if there's some money to be made, I will. But what I've done now is I've bought them so cheap that I can sell them really cheap and hopefully get them away.
The castle is an impressive and vast place to visit, but most of its contents are listed and strictly off limits to Drew. He's going to have to work hard to come away with more than just the cabinets.
Where are we off to now?
We're going to just have a quick peek in here. I'm afraid it's a bit like taking a diabetic in a sweetie shop, because you can't...
Oh,
you
my can't, word.
You can't have most of it, but there might be a couple of little bits.
Ooh, the domes. Have you got the bases? No.
I'm not sure there are for those three. I've got another one somewhere that is complete. No good without bases on.
Without bases, well... Not really. The one with the base, yes,
right.
For sure.
OK. We'll go and see that one, then.
Yeah, let's go and have a look at that one. I might have a go at those ones. These three glass domes don't have the base, which is a pain, but there's another one that does have the base. So what I'm thinking, we can put four or five together, get the bases for the other ones made, sell them as a group. They always sell well, and they look fantastic in the shop or at fairs with pieces in.
Rastera. So we were looking for... Oh, a glass stone with a base on it.
We'll even throw the doll in for tea to play with.
You haven't got that one, have you?
No. Not in the collection.
These 19th-century English glass display domes were individually hand-blown by skilled Victorian artisans, designed to display prized objects and keep them free of dust and dirt. Once refurbished, they could sell for £200 each.
What would you want for the four of those, then? So the ones without a base and then this one with the base.
We'll make an offer, Drew, I don't know.
Well, the other three without the bases are just a problem, really. They're sort of spares, and you can't do a great deal with them. This one here, I'd probably, if I had to, go a maximum of 100 quid on it. I wouldn't pay any more for it. It's just what it is. It is what it is.
Take the boss's hand.
Thank you, Drew.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Cheers.
I can pay £100 for all of the domes, can't pay any more. You could put them in a shop, or you could just have them at home with whatever you want to put in them. And it does make them look slightly more important, interesting, and definitely more attractive.
With buying opportunities exhausted, it's time for some fun.
Right, blimey, look at this.
Drew may have been bang on target with his offers inside, but Francis has a medieval surprise outside that could be a little more challenging.
Now, to pull the string, you're going to use three fingers, and it's the old Boy Scouts, so look at these three here. So I usually just put my thumb and pinky together.
Yeah.
All right, and then you put them underneath your arrow. And then you basically just point it up at the target and let it go when you're ready.
As easy as that?
Just as easy as that. Right?
Good, that.
Ooh, nearly. I was aiming right for the middle of the head. Just pretend they're French. Yes, got him.
Practice over. Oh. It's time to up the ante.
All right, T, the ultimate test.
Yeah.
You go and put that on your head. Stand over there. Go on, be all right.
Is this overtime?
Yeah, it's fine. Go on, I'm really good at it now. I'll put it this way. If I miss, you'll never know anything about it anyway. All right, T, steady. Stop crying. Stop shaking.